Well, there is a line from the new Best of Bridge cookbook. It is that slow cookers are like good friends. The better you get to know them, the stronger your relationship becomes. So I would say these two ladies agree. We have Sally Von Johnston and Mary Halpin, two of the Best of Bridge ladies, sharing your slow cooker ideas today. So I can already smell the onions and garlic. So what are we making?
Well, we're making Friday Fiesta chicken stew. And what you can smell is, as you said, the onions and the garlic. And I just added some...
So good.
I just added cumin, oregano and salt. And in here, I have some chicken thighs.
Okay.
Skin off, bone in. Lots of flavor with that, right? Works really well in the slow cooker. So we're going to turn this off so we don't set fire to ourselves.
Good.
And we can add this now into the
slow cooker.
Now, no. The reason we like to sauté the... just to soften the vegetables like this... is it just gives you a better flavor in the slow cooker.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to brown the meat, but it's really nice just to soften up the veggies like that.
Okay.
So we'll put that over there. And I'm going to add good old can of tomatoes, diced or whole in juice, just add that. And some, a little bit of sugar. It,
okay.
Yeah, it just gives it a really, just a little bit of a sweet kick there.
Yeah, I don't know that I would ever argue with sugar in a recipe.
And a little bit of chicken broth. And did you see what I've done there? I've assembled dinner. So all you do is put the lid on now, switch it on to low for about 5 or 6 hours,
okay.
Go off and do your business, come back,
and it's
open
done.
The door,
and
it's done.
The best thing about all these things that Sally's doing is that the Best of Bridge women for all those years were developing recipes, but we didn't do slow cooker recipes. So now Sally has developed all these recipes, and she's teaching us.
Nice.
And she has taken a whole bunch of our old recipes and converted them to slow cooker recipes.
Fantastic.
So that they all work.
So if you have favorites from the Best of Bridge, you can now you can just do it quicker.
You can. And then what we do at the end, once this is cooked, one of the big complaints people have about slow cooker food is that it's all one colour. Ooh, it's mushy. Ooh,
right,
it all
yeah,
tastes
okay.
the same. So what we do at the end of this, we keep some little, some vegetables such as corn or this is
okay.
sweet bell peppers.
Yep.
Add them about 15 minutes before the end. All you want to do, you...
Don't have to cook them, yeah?
Yeah, don't really have to cook them.
Right.
Heat them through for nice crispy... We just stir those in and then maybe add... we like to add some chipotle pepper at the end.
Okay.
Because if you add it at the beginning in a slow cooker, you can kind of lose the effect. It gets kind of muted.
Mm-hmm.
So we add it at the end. Mary's going to...
I am.
Just stirring
that in.
Stir it in. Oh, it doesn't want to come out.
Yeah.
Oh, just use your fingers.
Use your fingers.
We'll pretend that you're at home.
Really?
No one would argue.
Peppers.
We're going to add in the corn.
Yeah.
And we're going to add in this. And you just put the lid on and let it, you know, you pour your first glass of wine of the evening.
Yes.
So you suggested 5 hours. What if you're gone, you know, if you leave in the morning and work all day, can you leave it longer?
The chicken, probably not. Chicken
okay.
tends to kind of disintegrate into string.
Right, yes.
But other recipes such as pork and beef, obviously,
mm-hmm.
soups, they can definitely be left for at least 8 hours on a low setting. And those are the things that are really good to pick.
And you know what? One of the reasons people are interested in slow cookers, again, is the technology has improved.
Oh, I was going to say, I have one that my mom got when she was married, I believe,
yeah.
as a gift. And this part doesn't come out. So to wash it, you have to put
yes.
the whole thing in
oh,
the sink.
I know,
it's
awful.
And you know what
no
this one will do?
It.
If you're caught on in traffic on the bridge, this one will go from cooking low or high to warm, and it'll hold it.
Okay.
So you won't have overcooked food when you get home, which it used
Fantastic.
To used to happen before.
This looks lovely. So it's all it's kind of fallen off the bone. Look how
oh,
colourful
yeah.
it is. You see, people always say, "Oh, it's you know, all monochromatic in a slow cooker." And we're going to add a little bit of our cilantro. Love it or hate it. We love it.
Right. And if you don't love it, then don't put it on.
And don't put it on.
Yeah.
Exactly. Another reason to leave it till the end. Sprinkle of cheese. If you want, you can add some, you know, pumpkin seeds. They're always good with Mexican-style food.
Yep.
Sour cream, whatever. Now, please don't tell me that you think slow cooker food is monochromatic. Look at that.
I see a lot of different colors in there.
So
in my younger years, I've come to realize my grandparents have a cattle farm, and I thought the only thing you could ever make in a slow cooker was beef stew.
Well, you can
make
that.
Because they only cooked beef because they had cattle. But as it turns out, you can do pretty much everything in a slow cooker. I've seen pasta, rice, everything.
You can. Pasta, rice, baked goods. You can make to go
with... Oh, see, that I hadn't done.
You can make a fantastic cornbread to go with this. We have a couple of recipes for cornbread. It cooks beautifully. I know it sounds weird, doesn't it? Just follow the instructions.
I believe you, yeah.
And you know what Sally did? She took one of her all-time favorites, Christmas Morning Wife Saver.
Yes.
And you can actually make it in the slow cooker. We couldn't believe it, and it works beautifully.
It's now Christmas Eve Wife Saver.
Yes.
Just have to rename it. Okay, so where can people get this new book?
Anywhere that books are sold, really.
Perfect.
But we are tomorrow night at Costco in Sherwood Park
mm-hmm.
signing between 6 and 8 p.m. So if anybody's...
Oh, we'd love to see you.
We'd love to see you.
Yeah.
We'd love to see you. Come on down.
Bring your old books, too. You can
and
sign
you know
them
what?
All.
Just
people
don't bring
do.
A slow cooker.
Oh, I bet they do.
People do, and they're all, you know, covered with coffee and grease stains. And that's the ultimate compliment.
Yes, that you know they're being used. Okay, so that is October the 19th, tomorrow night, 6
yep.
to 8 p.m., Sherwood Park, Costco. Of course, you can always find that information on our website as well. So thanks for coming in. You make it look so easy. I believe it.
Of course we do.